he said that just after his inauguration, he was on the Today Show. And he said, if I can't get this economy turned around in 3 years, I'll be looking at a one-term proposition. We're here to collect. We're here to collect. I actually think to create jobs, it helps to have had a job. And I have. And I want to use that experience to get America working again. How am I going to solve these problems? How am I going to solve the problem of the massive deficits and the huge debt that's overlaying our country right now? And understand, of course, that this debt is a problem not only for us and for our current economy, but particularly for our kids and our grandkids. Because the idea of year after year passing on massive debts that we know we'll never repay and that our kids and grandkids are going to be burdened with, that's unacceptable to me. And so here's what I'll do. I will take all the programs of the federal government, list them out, how much they cost, and then I'll ask this question for each one as a test, which is this program so critical to our country that we should continue to borrow money from China to pay for it? And on that basis, I'm going to get rid of some programs. Some programs are easy to get rid of. First one I get rid of is Obamacare. We'll get rid of that. That's about $100 billion a year. The National Endowment for the Arts and the National Endowment for the Humanities are wonderful programs, but they're going to have to stand on their own because we're not going to borrow money for our kids to have to pay back for programs we don't have to have. And by the way, I like PBS. I like Big Bird. You know, I like Bert and Ernie and Big Bird, but you know, we give money from the government so they don't have to have advertising. I'm afraid Big Bird is going to have to get used to Kellogg's cornflakes. We're going to have to, we just can't keep borrowing and borrowing and borrowing and pretending like there's no tomorrow. And giving jobs back, how do you get jobs back? You make America the most attractive place in the world, as it has been for hundreds of years, for entrepreneurs and innovators, for job creators. So they want to invest here. So they grow here. So they build jobs here. That's what you got to do. And how do you do that? One, you make sure that our tax rates for employers are competitive with other nations. Two, you get regulators and regulations to encourage the private sector as opposed to just burdening it. Three, you open new markets for American goods and you crack down on cheaters like China that steal our intellectual property, our designs and patents. And you also take advantage of something we have in abundance. Oil, natural gas, coal. It's time for us to be energy secure. You see, the president's run out of ideas, and he's running out of excuses. And in 2012, with your help, he's run out of time. We'll get that job done.